start.
Good morning, sir and ma'am. Our IBM project presentation is on Park and Go. So we will be covering this all the things: introduction, system design, database, implementation, API, future scope, and conclusion. So firstly, let me discuss introduction. So what is the goal of this application? So basically, in a simple way, if you want to understand that you have your car with you and you want to park at a specific location. So that location, when you will click on park my car button, that current location of user will be fetched and stored into database. Now when you return after 1 or 2 hours and you are at another location and you want to find your car, that where you have parked, you have forgotten your car. So that location will also be fetched, and from that both locations a path will be drawn on Google Map that will help you to navigate to find your car. So this is a simple basic aim of this application. System design is, as we all know, that firstly user have to sign up, then register, user have to register, then he will have to log in himself, and last one is logout. So after registering, he will log in into the application. Then firstly, he will be redirected to a home page where a menu is given, that add car, select car, find car, park my car, and history. These 5 buttons are given. So after home, firstly he will have to add his vehicle number. If you have 2 or 3 cars, then you can add multiple cars. So after you add your car, then you have to select your car from that drop down, that which car you are currently parking. So after selecting that car number, you will click on park my car. So your that car number along with your location will be stored into a database. So here, park vehicle and store location, this will be stored into database. Now after you return after 1 or 2 hours, you have to find your car. So you will click on find car button. Then I have placed one intent which will redirect you to Google Maps application. Google application. So in that application, a path will be drawn from connecting both these locations, so you can navigate through that path. And the last one is view all records, means previous parking locations you can view, means on which date and at which time you have parked your car, that you can view in view all records.
So what is vehicle number?
If you have 2 or 3 cars, suppose you are traveling with car number 1, 2, 3, 4, another is 5, 6, 7, 8, and you have to park 1, 2, 3, 4 car number. So you can select from that after adding how many cars you have. A simple means application you have that is made is, firstly, when user will open, I have placed 2 buttons, register and login. So register, I have placed 4 visit fields that user will be required: name, is email, password, and confirm password. Then he will log in into the application. Then it is the home page, user activity. Firstly, you have to add your car. How many cars you have? You have to give that car registration number. After you will add your car, here you will be displayed your car list, 3 or 4 cars, how many you have added. Then this one is park car. So currently I have placed a toast which shows the location when I was developing the app. So when you click on park car, this application, means this location, will be stored in database. Now after you return and you click on find car, so your current location at that time, after 2 hours or half, whatever time, that also will be fetched. And after you click on find car, so using that both locations, our intent will be placed, which will show you how to navigate to that location, and history will show the details of your previous parking locations. Simple car number you can here add here, registration number. Now here I have placed latitudes and longitudes using geocoder. So latitude and longitude of park car will be here, and your find car means where you currently are. So using these both 2 fields, a path will be traced, and following this path you can reach to your location. So this is for navigating to find your car where you have parked it.
So you'll have to enter values there to get back?
No, it will automatically be given. Using intents, I have passed latitude and longitude of current and desired location.
6.9 kilometers.
Yeah, just a demo that I have used.
And one more thing, like the use case, as it says, like once you park your car, so you are walking, right? So automatically, does your app pick up saying, okay, that he started walking, so probably.
No, that I have not done. That we have not done. Just where you are and where your car is, that path only it will trace.
So you have to click on that button to.
Yeah, park car for parking your car and find car to get to your car.
Good morning sir, my name is Karan Solanki and in this project I did database design part. For that I have created main three tables for vehicle details, user detail and location detail. First of all, vehicle details, user detail, I have put four properties, which is user ID, name, email ID and password. And in this table, user ID will be, I have given a foreign key for that. Then same as for location table, I have put four properties: location ID, vehicle ID, location and date and time. Same way in vehicle details, I have put three properties: vehicle detail, user ID and vehicle number. For these three table, I have put two relationship, which is one to many relationship. For accessing one table property, more than one property to other tables. These are the list of APIs which we need to for our project, which is registration, login, add vehicle number, then select vehicle number, park vehicle, fetch parking location, view old records and for logout.
Login logout, what APIs you need?
Ma'am, API part is
in login, you just check.
We have matched credentials.
Credentials, email ID and password.
If email is given and corresponding password, both are same valid, then only it will enter into the application.
For logout, just we have redirected.
So this is the basic flow model of our project. As a new user, your user has to register first, then after registration, our application will redirect the user to login page. And after validation of user, it will redirect to our main home page of our application. In that, we will provide three buttons: add vehicle, select vehicle number and logout button. So in select vehicle number, we will further provide three more buttons for find vehicle, park vehicle and view record of all parking vehicles.
So this is a flow of login and logout. Here, if you have account, then you need not to register for this. You can directly login, and then we have applied validation that this is valid or not. According to that, if this is not valid, this is redirect over here. That you if what you say if you want to register later, you have to register for that. Then if it's valid, you have to go for home page. From anywhere of here you have to exit, you can end the from the application. After home page, you have to select a vehicle number. After selecting vehicle number, you are able to find your car or park your car or view the record of that car record. Same as register, that you have to register. Then if some things are not really, like you are typing name and you are adding some number over there, then it will give some errors over there. So that we have included some validations.
So who's got the mobile app?
Same as add vehicle, for adding vehicle, I have to add a number from then it will stored in database and then we'll redirect to home page. Then we can select a vehicle number and then operate another operation. Same as selecting a vehicle number, then we are checking that number is valid. We are having 10 digit number, that TJ1 and all. After number is valid, then we can
pick the list from
sorry
from the list only, right? right? How it can go in manner? You're selecting the vehicle number from the list, right?
Assuming a user has three vehicles and
yes,
already
yes.
has three, so anyway is stored. So why do you need a validation?
Yeah, here
okay.
it is not required.
Yeah,
okay,
that is
in adding vehicle
only
we require.
Adding vehicle, that is only. First question is, see, at any point of time I am adding only one vehicle. Right? Why do you need to add a vehicle?
If you have multiple vehicles.
No, ma'am.
Currently.
No, ma'am. That's not like we have included the system. Like if you are having three cars. And if you are driving different cars different time, then if you want to store, you are riding first car now, so then you can store, select that vehicle here, that vehicle number over here, and next operation will perform according to that vehicle.
Understood.
You don't have to log in with another user to use another car. If we will include your car number in registration, then you have to create different users for different cars. Here, from one user, you can access different cars.
My question is, okay, I have two cars. Okay, today now, it's only one car, correct?
Okay.
So without the adding the number, I'm just thinking. I don't need to add my number. At this point of time, I'm adding only one car. I go somewhere, I park my car, and then automatically all this location captures all that. I go find out all that, it's fine. I'm done with this car. Next, I go with the other car, maybe in the afternoon.
Yes.
It's only that car, I don't need to know which car I used earlier, what time. I'm not
because
clear
when
why
you are carrying it is useful in history.
Huh?
If you want to see previous parking locations and you do not
why,
add car.
What is the use case? Why I need to know?
Means it is for
actually,
some
ma'am,
analytics. In future scope, you want to analyze that how many kilometers you travel. It's a kind of that data collection and analysis.
But travel is okay, but why
because
you,
existing
you,
applications
why
we studied.
You need to know the previous parking history.
Because when the project is given to us, that sir told us that I need the previous record of this specific car list. So we have included this model,
because
this functionality. Yes.
This was given.
Yeah.
I have asked him,
but he said that I require this functionality
okay.
over here. So that,
okay. I mean,
that's
why. The question why I'm asking is, I want to know that whether you guys thought about it.
Yeah.
Given
any
project,
that time
it should not be somebody giving you or just doing it. If
yes.
you guys think about why this use case, why it is, I mean, you have to question that. That's where I'm asking you whether
yeah.
you thought about all this.
Okay. Here for finding vehicle location, you have to select car, then you will click on find location, then it will find the location of that car from database where data was stored, then it will found the car, and if it found, it will redirect to Google Map where you can see the path of that, and then will redirect to home page, and if not, you have to try it again. So as park vehicle, you have to park that car, and if location not found, you have to try again. That if at that location is not fetched by some internet issue or all. And that if location found, it will store in database and redirect to home page. These are the data which we have entered and stored over.
Okay. Another question. So let's say like I park my car at some location. It is so very close by ago. I'm just not very far, right? And then I want to. I know where my car is. I don't have to use the app now. But before I just stopped my car, I registered in this app. Okay. I parked this location. The app captured it.
Yes.
Okay. Then when I come out, I know that okay. You know, my car is here. I don't have to use the app. So I just come and start. So what happens to this?
That data will be stored in database.
Uh-huh.
Another time you go and park your car and you are far and you forgot. Then a new entry will be created.
No,
that entry will
be current entry
will
still be open,
right? No, means it will be there in database, but it will not affect your results for finding your car.
That's nothing like that last
previous location will not affect your search results.
We have declared that last location is closed. In case, like,
unless it closed, I can't use the next one, right? You got me.
But we are doing with date and time.
You can.
What I can? I came here, I didn't use the application to log out. My current location, it is still open, my current location. Now I go to another place, I park my car. So now I want to use the app. So how would I do it? I create a new entry or the existing one to close and then start?
New entry will be created along with date and time. So your previous means last updated date and time, that value it will fetch, not the previous one.
So previous one we just hanging, that's all, nothing can be done.
No. Yes. It is not deleted from the database.
We have to create a new entry because after some time we have they need an old record. So I have to fetch that old record from database. So we have stored, and like for finding car we have applied query like from we have in descending order we are fetching the last date and time.
Last one, but still the old one you have no means to close it. Yes, under the user goal. That will be stored in database. Yes, how it can happen is very practical situation. Yeah, my car is closed, so there will not be any situation like you will get a previous location. So what is also the precision that you have? Say for example, if the parking of the five cars parked around you. If everybody is using the same
as a precision will depend on this because Google Maps, because I have passed intent to Google Map. So how much accurately it shows your location there.
Have you done some fine tuning there in terms of how many?
No sir, that I have not done because directly I have used Google Map API and passed latitudes and longitudes. So the resolution that map is providing, that will be there for the application.
So there is a JSON output which we are backend team will give to the front end. We will see demo first.